They had a giant problem. They needed a champion, someone who would go and fight on their behalf, because they were terrified and thought there was no way they could ever win. Today we remember that we have a champion in Jesus Christ. He came to this earth to be a single combat warrior. He went to war against our greatest enemies, sin, death, and the devil. And on this day, as we watch him be led out into the desert to be tempted by Satan, we see the battle joined. He takes on our most terrible enemies, and the Son of God goes to war for you to do what you could not. Today, Jesus wants to remind you that there is no problem in your life, no sin so great, no sorrow so deep that he will not pick it up and carry it for you. Because all the gigantic problems in our life, they find their solution in Jesus. It's just hard to remember that when life gets rough. That's what happened to the people of Israel in our first reading for today. The people of God, they had a giant problem, and they didn't know how to fix it. His name was Goliath from Gath, and this warrior stood 9 feet tall, a giant of a man. He was the champion for the nation of Philistia, the enemies of God's people, and he would stand out between the battle lines and demand that Israel send their bravest man to fight him. "Fight me," he said. That's what giants do. They taunt you and scare you and dare you. And King Saul, all the Israelites, they were terrified. You know, isn't that what happens so often in our life when we're you're going along, things are going well, life seems to be going pretty good, then all of a sudden a giant problem comes walking into your life. And it's bigger than you, and it's stronger than you, and you just don't know what to do about it. I don't know, what's the giant that's walked into your life? Is it your marriage? Is it an addiction that has you in its grips? Is it that one habitual sin that just makes you dance like a puppet on a string? Whatever it is, all those giant problems have one thing in common. A giant problem tells you that your God is not in control. That's what Goliath was doing to the people of Israel, right? I mean, remember, the people of Israel had been promised that land, but here was a giant standing in their way. And with every word that he spoke, he was shouting, "You can't stop me, and your God doesn't care." Isn't that the same thing that the giant problems in our life shout to us? When cancer says, "You can't stop me, and your God doesn't care." When your broken family or your broken finances are shouting, "You can't stop me, and your God doesn't care." That's what giants do. The question, though, is what do we do about them? I think this is a place where we don't want to learn any lessons from King Saul. King Saul and his army, they thought that maybe if they just ignored the giant, it would go away. Didn't work. Day after day, Goliath came out and stood between the lines and defied the armies of Israel. Day after day, Saul and his men didn't know what to do, so they just didn't do anything, but the giant was still there intimidating them and harassing them and taunting them, because that's what giants do. That's what they do in our life too, don't they? When we think we can just ignore the giant problem that's there, like the relationship or that addiction or that brokenness, We think we just close our eyes and wait it out, it'll get better. If we just wait long enough. The trouble is, though, you can't ignore giants. They're not going anywhere. But God would have us learn a lesson today. The way you deal with giants is you don't ignore them. The way you deal with giants is that you kill them. You kill them. That was something God needed to teach his Old Testament people. And he also, in these words, wants to teach us today too. But you don't ignore the giant problems in your life, you kill them. But killing a giant means you have to have the right perspective. And you have to have the right kind of strength. King Saul and his soldiers, they were looking at Goliath and seeing this 9-foot warrior, and they looked up and he was bigger than them and stronger than them. They felt hopeless and they felt helpless. They didn't know what to do. And you know what? When a giant walks into our life, a giant problem, we can feel the same way. We can look up at this thing that is bigger than me and stronger than me, and I don't even begin to know how to address it. I don't begin to know, how can I do anything about that? When you look up, you start to feel hopeless and helpless. But when we do that, I wonder, are we failing to see things in the proper perspective? Because you know what? Yes, your failing marriage is a giant bigger than you. It is. Your diseased body is a giant bigger than you. The sin and the guilt you carry around, that is a giant bigger than you. They are bigger than you, but you know what? That's not the point. They are not bigger than your God. They are not bigger than your God. The Lord was going to show his people what that meant. And so he sent his young shepherd named David. David one day would be king of Israel, but today when we see him, he's a shepherd. He's got nothing but a sling, a stone, and one gigantic faith in the God Most High. And you know, David, he's a guy that's got the right perspective. You know, he takes a look at Goliath and all of his strength and all of his power, and you know what he saw? He saw someone who could not, should not, and would not defy God anymore. Listen to what he said. He says, "Who is this Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" Great perspective. He didn't say Saul's army, did he? The army of the living God. He said, if God is on our side, if this is God's battle, and he's fighting for us, but who does this guy think he is? This 9-foot-tall monster is not a problem with God on our side, because that giant is nothing compared to God. You know, when we see the giant problems in our life, we look up at them when we feel helpless and hopeless, because we're not seeing them in perspective. You have to look up past them. You know what you're going to see? If you look a little taller than 9 feet, you are going to see the love of God looming over your life. I mean, think about this. This is the God who loved you so much, he was willing to die on a cross in your place. Do you really think he's not going to love you through this? I mean, this is the God who loved you so much, he went to death and came back again so that you will never die. Do you really think he's not going to love you through this giant problem in your life right now? This is the God who sits on his heavenly throne and promises that right now he is ruling all things for the good of his church. Do you really think that he's forgotten about you and the problem that you're facing? We have to look at these things in perspective, my friends. Our problems only look like giants because you and I are so short. But they are nothing compared to our God. Besides perspective, I think the other thing that's really important when we're facing these giant problems in our life is to find the right source of strength. I think we can go looking for strength in the wrong places. King Saul, when he heard somebody was willing to fight the giant, he was pretty excited about that. Had the young man brought into him, and he was going to give him some giant slaying tips, which I get a kick out of, because, of course, if Saul knew anything about slaying a giant, maybe he should have gone out and done it. In fact, Saul, we were told, is the tallest man in Israel. But he didn't want to go try it with this 9-foot man, Goliath. Saul's idea about how to fight giants was maybe you should get the best equipment money can buy. And so he offered David his own armor. You can have the best stuff. Here, take the king's armor. That was an earthly answer. Sometimes we go looking for earthly answers to our giant problems too. You know, like if I feel guilty about something, well, I just need to find a therapist who tells me that there's nothing wrong with it. Stop feeling guilty about it. If my family's strained, I think, well, I better just take them on a nicer vacation. That's going to really pull us back together. Or if there's that sin that I struggle with again and again, what do? I just rationalize it. Make an excuse. Say it's not that big a deal. Those are earthly answers. And they don't do you any good when you're facing a giant problem. David looked down at Saul's suggestions and knew this was never going to work. He knew that there was only one way that he could fight this giant, and that's if God was fighting on his side. And so David, he goes out to meet Goliath with no armor, no helmet, no sword. He's just got a sling, a stone, and the Spirit of the Lord Almighty. And Goliath laughed at the boy, foolish enough to fight him. And David preached to the giant, foolish enough to defy God. Listen to what David said. You have come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will hand you over to me, and I'll strike you down. And the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. All those gathered here will know it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves, for the battle is the Lord's. Picture that scene. Little David, the shepherd, towering Goliath, the warrior. This is the most uneven battle in history. And Goliath charges to the battle line, 700 pounds of man and metal. And what does David do? He runs to the fight. Down the hill he goes, that sling whipping in his hand, and David, strong in the Spirit of the Lord. Goliath, with all of his height and all of his power, David slung that stone, and Goliath was struck square, and 700 pounds of man and metal came crashing at David's feet. Because the battle is the Lord's. Brothers and sisters, I know you have giant problems in your life. We all do. But remember, the battle is the Lord's. The battle is the Lord's. And Jesus Christ, he died and rose again to open the gates of heaven to you, and he's invited us to follow after him. And he comes to you with a promise today. There is nothing, no problem so big, no sin so great, that can take away the peace you have in Jesus. It's a promise. He says, when we see the giant problems in our life, he says, look up and you will see the love of God looming over your life. Look up and you will see promises of God that are meant to get us through every storm that comes our way. What will separate us from the love of Christ? The danger, the fear, the nakedness or sword? No. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. God grant it. Amen. The peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.